question for you. Mm-hmm. Are loan officers still necessary? And what I mean by that is you see so many of these online, LendingTree.com and this, that, and the third, you know, where you can bypass. Is it necessary to form a relationship with a loan officer? And if so, what's the best way to do it? Do I walk into my local bank branch? Like, how do I even form a relationship with a loan officer?
Great question. So you know I'm a little biased on this one. But I'll keep it a buck, right? Do you need a loan officer? Hell yeah. It's very simple, right? It's like going to court and you trying to defend yourself. Although you can.
Great analogy.
It's not recommended too, because you don't know the law. So you can go on LendingTree, you can go to these computer sites and you can punch in your information. Great, you get a pre-approval letter, you go out shop for a home, and then now when you actually go submit your documentation, you get declined. Like, because you put in the wrong information, right? There's so many guidelines, there's so many regulations in our business that if you're not talking to someone, then if it could come up at the 99th hour and kill your deal. And I've seen it happen. Now, there's been a lot of success stories where people using online platforms, they feel like it's better for them. They just want to buy their primary residence. They don't have no goals of investing long-term. Great. That may suit their need, right? But for the folks out there who are looking to build a real estate portfolio, you need a mortgage guy. You need a mortgage girl. You need someone who understands the ever-changing guidelines, the laws. How do you structure these deals to achieve your goals? You know, going to your local bank, I tell people this all the time. There's nothing wrong with going to the bank that you have money with, but understand that person works only with that bank. They're going to adhere to that bank's guidelines. And depending on what bank you're going to, their guidelines can be strict than what the rest of the mortgage companies out there are offering. So you want to be able to have a relationship with a mortgage person that can handle your primary residence, that can handle your investment properties. Hell, if you're looking to go buy some commercial properties in the future, you need to work with someone who's knowledgeable. That way, anytime you have a question, like, all right, let me call my guy, let me call my girl, because I got this question real quick, and I know they can answer it. Most of the times, if you go online to an online lender or you go into your local bank, that person or that online platform is only interested in that one transaction you're talking about. If you really think about this, right, if you go talk to a loan officer, and anybody in your audience can do this, if they don't ask you what your real estate goals are, they're really out for your best interest, right? They just want to know about this one deal that's on the table right now, because we have quotas we have to meet. We are commissioned salespeople. If we don't kill, we don't eat for the most part, right? So if you come into a bank and you say, hey, I want to get pre-approval, I want to refinance, they're worried about that one application. How can I get you in and get you closed as quickly as possible so that way you're happy and I'm happy, right? Mm-hmm. Me, on the other hand, I'm more about the relationship. What's your short-term? What's your long-term goals? And now can I match up the products that meet your goals, not just for deal one, but for deal 10? Because if you mess up on deal one, that can hurt you for deal 2, 3, and 4. I've seen it happen many, many times before, and it's because people are not having that conversation. People got to build teams, Shawn. You have to have a team. Like, you can't be successful in anything without having a team. And in real estate, it's the same thing. If you know you want to do buying flips, right, you need contractors. You can't say, hey, I want to flip properties, and you don't know no contractors. That just doesn't make no sense. Right. You want to buy rental properties. Are you going to manage them? If not, do you know any property managers? Do you have real estate attorneys? Right. Do you have life insurance? Because if you're buying these assets, now you need to protect those assets. Do you have a trust? Do you have an estate lawyer? Do you have a CPA? Right. Very important. Right. Generational wealth and what people and I know I'm going on a rant, but people need to
run. And you're probably going over some people's head because Just go a little slower and break.
Yeah, because I'm hyped right now.
Yeah,
because
right? You're saying CPA, certified public accountant. I want to make sure that the audience follows you.
So CPA is certified public accountant, right? You need these people in your life because they understand real estate taxes. One of the best things about real estate is the tax deductions. And this is why most people want to go out and invest, because it saves you on taxes. But if you're not working with a professional who understands the tax laws, especially for real estate, then that can hurt you, right? That's money for you and your family and part of your wealth. So long story short, you just have to build a team. And your loan officer, your mortgage person is very important piece to building a team.
Got you. What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.